As for chapters of Quran, I will tell you in other surahs, which known as surahs. I will tell you what it mean by the chapters of Quran. This is just this video, the purpose of this video is just expose the fabrication against God and His book. So God preserved His book throughout the messengers, and He will be keep preserving it. If book is insulted or humiliated, He will add one more verse. That's simple for God, and nobody can erase it. Nobody has the courage to erase it. Now as for Makki and Madani Surah, Indo-Pak and Persian, Iraq, Iran and Indo-Pak, those are the people who are the biggest one when it comes to idolizing Muhammad and his family or his disciples. They are the one who come up with the idea of Makki and Madani. They talk about, oh, we do not add, no, we cannot add any word in the Quran. No, that's a sin. They are the one who add Makki and Madani chapters of Quran. Because in oldest Quran, you do not find that. You do not find that. Makki and Madani. How they know this is Makki and Madani when the oldest Quran is not even talking about Makki or Madani. Just the lies about Book of God. That's all. Now some prophets of Quran are mentioned inside the Quran by their title. And what are those? Few of them are Ar-Ra'd. There is a surah on the name of Ar-Ra'd. Al-Mudassir, Al-Muzammil. When it's come to Shia and Sunni, they say Mudassir is Muhammad's name, Muzammil is Muhammad's name. Muhammad has so many names. Maybe in future they're gonna say Jesus is also Muhammad's name. It's a second name Muhammad. They probably, because whole religion is, with the passage of time, always added something, always added something, always added something. So that's why. So it started the revelation of Quran. The first verse started from 500 AD, 517 AD till 1517 AD. 1000 years. After 1500 AD or from 1500 AD, you guys seeing the complete Quran. The one in Turkey Museum is not oldest copy of Quran. And now when historians say, they think, oh, no, this is the oldest. This is complete. This is older. No. The complete Quran must be completed around 14th to 15th century AD. Not before that. Do whatever you want to do. 15th century AD, 500 years ago, not too long ago, 500 years ago. From 500 AD to 1500 AD, 1000 year of gap. If God add any verse into a Quran by His prophet, that means it is word of God. So that's why a lot of, now this is also very important question I'm going to expose now. Very important thing I'm going to expose now. Lot of Christian and Jews, lot of translators, what they did when it say, it used the word Ahlul Kitab. Ahlul Kitab mean owner of the book. Okay? Owner of the book. Everywhere what Muslim translator did, they put the Jews and Christian in there, in the translation. Okay, Ahlul Kitab mean the one who have a Bible, they are the Ahlul Kitab, since these are the rightly guided one, believers. Okay? Actually, that's not the case. Most of the Quran, where Ahl al-Kitab used, it was used only for those who had the different copies of Quran. Different copies of Quran mean here not that like a different, you know, everybody has their own copy. No. What I mean here is that, I mean, one group has a, let's say, Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter number 2. Okay. And there's another group who has Al Imran, chapter number 3 of Quran, in their possession. Now, both group has these two chapters in their possession. They both were known as Ahl al-Kitab, the owner of the book, because this one has a book in their possession and that one also has a book in their possession. You understand? That's what it means, the owner of the book. It does not mean where it refers inside the Quran. Ahl al-Kitab is always Jews and Christian, always Jews. Very simple history. And Christian also think that is true.